Due to dangers, OpenAI canceled GPT-5. Or did they? GPT-5 expectations. In a discussion about threats posed by AI systems, Sam Altman, OpenAI CEO and co-founder, has confirmed that the company is not currently training GPT-5, the presumed successor to its AI language model GPT-4 released this March. Speaking at an event at MIT, Altman was asked about a recent open letter circulated among the tech world that requested that labs like OpenAI pause development of AI systems more powerful than GPT-4. The letter highlighted concerns about the safety of future systems, but has been criticized by many in the industry, including a number of signatories. Experts disagree about the nature of the threat posed by AI. Is it existential or more mundane? As well as how the industry might go about pausing development in the first place. At MIT, Altman said the letter was missing most technical nuance about where we need the pause, and noted that an earlier version claimed that OpenAI is currently training GPT-5. We are not and won't for some time, said Altman. So in that sense, it was sort of silly. However, just because OpenAI is not working on GPT-5 doesn't mean it's not expanding the capabilities of GPT-4, or, as Altman was keen to stress, considering the safety implications of such work. We are doing other things on top of GPT-4 that I think have all sorts of safety issues that are important to address and were totally left out of the letter, he said. Altman's comments are interesting, though not necessarily because of what they reveal about OpenAI's future plans. Instead, they highlight a significant challenge in the debate about AI safety, the difficulty of measuring and tracking progress. Altman may say that OpenAI is not currently training GPT-5, but that's not a particularly meaningful statement. Some of the confusion can be attributed to what I call the fallacy of version numbers. The idea that numbered tech updates reflect definite and linear improvements in capability. It's a misconception that's been nurtured in the world of consumer tech for years, where numbers assigned to new phones or operating systems aspire to the rigor of version control, but are really just marketing tools. Well, of course, the iPhone 35 is better than the iPhone 34, goes the logic of the system. That's why Altman's confirmation that OpenAI is not currently developing GPT-5 won't be of any consolation to people worried about AI safety. The company is still expanding the potential of GPT-4 by connecting it to the internet, for example, and others in the industry are building similarly ambitious tools, letting AI systems act on behalf of users. There's all sorts of work that is no doubt being done to optimize GPT-4, and OpenAI may release GPT-4.5, as it did GPT-3.5 first. Another way that version numbers can mislead. Even if the world's governments were somehow able to enforce a ban on new AI developments, it's clear that society has its hands full with the systems currently available. Sure, GPT-5 isn't coming yet, but does it matter when GPT-4 is still not fully understood? In any case, experts have expressed their expectations from the upcoming model. Be it 4.5 or GPT-5, here's what we can learn from all of those opinions. When will GPT-5 be released? OpenAI released GPT-3 in June 2020 and followed it up with a newer version, internally referred to as DaVinci 002, in March 2022. Then came DaVinci 003, widely known as GPT-3.5. With the release of ChatGPT in November 2022, followed by GPT-4's release in March 2023. Based on the trajectory of previous releases, OpenAI may not release GPT-5 for several months. It may be further delayed due to a general sense of panic that AI tools like ChatGPT have created around the world. GPT-4 sparked multiple debates around the ethical use of AI and how it may be detrimental to humanity. It was shortly followed by an open letter signed by hundreds of tech leaders, educationists, and dignitaries, including Elon Musk and Steve Wozniak, calling for a pause on the training of systems more advanced than GPT-4. Since then, OpenAI CEO Sam Altman has claimed, at least twice, that OpenAI is not working on GPT-5. In June 2023, at a press event organized by the Economic Times in New Delhi, India, Altman said, We have a lot of work to do before GPT-5. It takes a lot of time. We are nowhere close to it. Primary expectations from GPT-5: more power, better pricing. GPT-4 is currently only capable of processing requests with up to 8,192 tokens, which loosely translates to 6,144 words. OpenAI briefly allowed initial testers to run commands with up to 32,768 tokens, roughly 25,000 words or 50 pages of context. And this will be made widely available in the upcoming releases. GPT-4's current length of queries is twice what is supported on the free version of GPT 3.5, and we can expect support for much bigger inputs with GPT-5. Notably, these larger queries also come at a price. While GPT 3.5 is free to use through ChatGPT, GPT-4 is only available to users in a paid tier called ChatGPT Plus. Pricing starts at $20 per month, which can be a deterrent. With GPT-5, as computational requirements and the proficiency of the chatbot increase, we may also see an increase in pricing. For now, you may instead use Microsoft's Bing AI Chat, which is also based on GPT-4 and is free to use. However, you will be bound to Microsoft's Edge browser, where the AI chatbot will follow you everywhere in your journey on the web as a co-pilot. Factual, correctness, and fewer hallucinations. Besides being better at churning faster results, GPT-5 is expected to be more factually correct. In recent months, we have witnessed several instances of ChatGPT, Bing AI Chat, or Google Bard spitting up absolute hogwash, otherwise known as hallucinations in technical terms. This is because these models are trained with limited and outdated datasets. For instance, the free version of ChatGPT based on GPT 3.5 only has information up to June 2021 and may answer inaccurately when asked about events beyond that. OpenAI claimed GPT-4 has much fewer hallucinations and performed 40% higher than GPT 3.5 in its internal adversarial functionality evaluations. GPT-4, moreover, has an 82% lower tendency to respond to sensitive requests or disallowed content, such as self-harm or medical inquiries. Despite these, GPT-4 exhibits various biases, but OpenAI says it's improving existing systems to reflect common human values and learn from human input and feedback. Eliminating incorrect responses from GPT-5 will be the key to its wider adoption in the future, especially in critical fields like medicine and education. Multimodal capabilities. GPT-4 lacks the knowledge of real-world events after September 2021, but was recently updated with the ability to connect to the internet in beta with the help of a dedicated web browsing plugin. Microsoft's Bing AI Chat, built upon OpenAI's GPT and recently updated to GPT-4, already allows users to fetch results from the internet. While that means access to more up-to-date data, you're bound to receive results from unreliable websites that rank high on search results with illicit SEO techniques. It remains to be seen how these AI models counter that and fetch only reliable results while also being quick. This can be one of those areas to improve with the upcoming models from OpenAI, especially GPT-5. In addition to web search, GPT-4 also can use images as inputs for better context. This, however, is currently limited to research preview and will be available in the model's sequential upgrades. Future versions, especially GPT-5, can be expected to receive greater capabilities to process data in various forms such as audio, video, and more. Meta recently released details about its multimodal AI model, ImageBind, which can process 6 different types of data: text, image, videos, audio, depth, and heat maps. One can easily expect OpenAI to also progress in this area by the time it releases GPT-5, making it more useful in various fields of work and not limiting it to operating merely as a chatbot or AI image generator. What do you think about the dangers of newer ChatGPT upgrades? Is it safe? We'd like to hear your thoughts in the comments below.
Remember to click the like button, subscribe, and ring the YT bell icon to stay updated.